3, 2, 1.
What's up, everyone? Dan here, Crypto Capital Venture, September 17th, 2018. Sorry, it's been a while. Haven't done a Bitcoin, Litecoin technical analysis for quite a few days now. Most of you probably know why that is, but we're going to do one right now, and I'm not even going to waste any time. I'm just going to jump right into the video. And I want to start with a tweet that I made earlier. I said the next short midterm resistance target for Bitcoin is right in the $69 to $7,100 channel, which is the 618 to 786 Fibonacci we're going to look at in a second, would start with nice lower trend line support kicking us off this new higher low in the coming days, you know, maybe 24, 48 hours, if not more. Have to break one of these channels eventually, right? And what I mean by that is this downtrend that we've been in for months, lower highs. We need to break one of those eventually, I hope. So let's jump into the charts and really see what's going on with Bitcoin. It's been a few days, so it's kind of exciting to do this video right now. There's a lot to look at. There's a lot to look for in terms of Bitcoin and Litecoin, and we're going to talk about both. I'm going to make it short and sweet for you guys. So we can start really by, let's get this out of the way. The downside, right? Everybody wants to know. And first, let me just say this. Right now, I think the moral of this video is to say, the whole market is so confused right now. Bullish, bearish, nobody knows what to think. And that's mainly because the consolidation that has taken place over the course of the last few weeks, few months. So it's just getting tighter and tighter. And it seems like it could really, obviously it can always go either way, but right now it's just seeming so up in the air and people are even having trouble getting emotional. They just don't even know how to feel anymore. So let's talk about this. Let's talk about the downside. The downside for me is easy. Anything above $5,700, like right around here in this channel, and we've had this channel on the screen for a while as we've been doing technical analysis. And really I liken it to the bottom that we had in this last bear market a few years ago, which is we had that initial bottom and then we kind of just like traded around a little bit for months actually. Right above this channel, and then we wicked back down, we tested that initial bottom, and then that was the end of the bear market, right? There was this final bottom channel that was formed in that bear market. And typically that's what happens, whether it's a double bottom, a triple bottom, that happens a lot. So right now, for me, I'm eyeing this area up as a nice area of support for possible bottom. So my first big target, and I wouldn't call it a target, I guess, but my first big area of support really is that $5,700 area. I'm really not too concerned with anything above that. So if we come down even more and we even break this nice little upper trend line of higher lows that we've been getting, if we break that trend line and go down to say here, 5,900, I'm really not too concerned. $5,700 is that area I'm really, really curious to see if we go to, if we get a nice bounce or even a nice wick through. We get a nice big long wick through that area on the daily, that next day might be a nice area to possibly accumulate a little bit more. So that's on the downside. That's what I'm looking at on the downside. Now we have this target area that I talked about in that tweet. And that's pretty self-explanatory if you read the tweet, which is really this previous swing high to this previous low right there. And there's the target, right? It's this 786 top, this 618 bottom, and we've done videos on this for so long and we've seen the consistency of how often both on the downside and upside Bitcoin sees this channel, this exact channel, for support and for resistance. And even in this long-term downtrend of lower highs that Bitcoin has had, you see all those lower highs, that 618 to 786 channel has really played a huge role in painting, being the paintbrush of telling this story of lower highs. So here we are again in the same exact situation. So for me, that's a really, really important, almost obvious target to look out for in terms of support. And I said in the tweet, will we finally get a breakthrough it, right? Will we break this previous lower high? Time will tell. I don't know when that's gonna happen, but maybe we get a run here and we get to see if we can do it. But obviously, as always, at the same time we did, or same thing we did the video talking about approaching that channel in this run, we talked about the 50 EMA being that first area of resistance. We had that nice daily candle, I remember it. We broke that area, which was nice. So right now, that's our first area of resistance, right around $6,700 on the upside. And then from there, our next area of resistance is right around $6,900 at that 618 on the Fibonacci. So again, I say this, I said it before, I won't be convinced otherwise until we stop seeing these lower highs with Bitcoin. If you are a trader, I'm sure many traders traded this and sold right here at that channel when we had that lower high. And so this could be a nice trading opportunity if you're a trader out there. I'm not, and it's not something I recommend or advise on, but I'm just saying and just throwing that out there that people probably are doing that. One thing I found interesting, and I want to point this out, is the MACD. I was looking at the MACD, right? And I was really kind of comparing it to the MACD from the bear market. And there are a lot of similarities. And I want to go over some bullet points because it's really interesting and I really think it's telling as well. And we can get some clues from the MACD. So a couple of things. Let's go to the chart. We're not using this MACD to determine overbought or oversold conditions. That's not the purpose of the MACD, and it's certainly not why I'm using it. We use a stochastic RSI, the RSI for that. But what we are using this is, or what we are using the MACD for, is to get a sense of momentum. The bulls versus the bears. Who's stronger? What are they doing? Where are they failing at in terms of the data points on the chart, right? And then we're also using it for consolidation insights. And it really is very illustrative of the consolidation that has taken place with Bitcoin. So, I wrote there, momentum is illustrated comparatively to the charts, because if you look at the charts, you can see momentum really, it's just kind of fading both ways, right? And what I mean by that is the bulls, they can't get any momentum, and you can see it on the actual MACD, right? They kind of fail, they burn out each time they get momentum, and that's kind of illustrative of those lower highs that we see. But on the flip side, right? On the flip side, what's happening is the bears are failing right now to break the bottom, and see, you have these higher lows on the MACD, and that's illustrative of the bears failing to basically, and let me try and open the chart here, basically break this channel in Bitcoin. That's what that's illustrative of. And you can see on the momentum oscillator. The momentum oscillator really is like just a really nice, simple, clean picture of what the markets are doing, what the bulls are doing, what the bears are doing, where they're failing. And it really helps us to kind of understand what may happen next. So for me, in terms of answering that question, what might happen next, I feel like anytime there's this crazy consolidation, right, and momentum has faded both ways, the bears and the bulls, it gets very uncertain. So this is really the boiling point of why we have this channel, and we always talk about anticipation, because it's coming close to possibly something happening quite soon on the upside or downside. I'm not here to say which side, but we are here to kind of get a sense of timing, and we are here to get a sense of possible targets on both ends. But we really just want to be ready in terms of our portfolio. Are we ready for the upside if you look at your portfolio? And are we ready for the downside if we look at your portfolio? Are you happy with your risk tolerance and the risk that you have in the game right now? So that's kind of what I'm looking at on Bitcoin. Like I said, anything above $5,700, I'm not too concerned. And I will probably be accumulating if we get into that area, depending on how quick we get into that area. So hopping over to Litecoin, and I'll sum this up pretty quickly. Obviously, we want to follow Bitcoin, but Litecoin, so Bitcoin has its nice little patterns that it's forming. It's been really trending nicely with the Fibonacci on the daily chart, but Litecoin also similarly has its own little patterns, and they're very synergistic and have been working very nicely with Bitcoin's moves as well. And one thing I mean by that is even just that $47 target. I can't remember what video it was that we talked about, though. We got that $47. Like, look at that. Look at that daily wick down to $47. And you can see this last wedge that we broke on the downside. You measure that from that breaking point on the downside. And you can see we fell right down into that $48, $47 area. And we talked about that as a target. So And it's not the first time it's happened. And we've been talking a lot about this in Litecoin, these wedges that are formed. Until Bitcoin decides it's going to break its lower highs, Litecoin needs to decide that it's going to break this trend of these little bear flags that are forming of these higher highs, these higher lows, and then breaking on the downside. I mean, it just keeps happening over and over again. So the question is, with where we are right now on the daily chart, you can see, is it going to happen again? And we can go to this chart over here. And right now you can kind of see, this is one thing I just want to point out in terms of that downside, like how many times are we going to break down, right? One thing that's interesting for me to watch is we're right now within this consolidation channel from last fall, where we saw Litecoin kind of consolidate sideways a little bit on the 50 EMA. The 50 EMA consolidating sideways with a symmetrical triangle type of deal happening back here, which you can see. It's a nice sign of consolidation, slowing down, trading sideways. You can see the 50 EMA, that blue line, just chilling out for a second, and then it went crazy. So it's the same thing. So the 50 EMA was kind of going up, consolidate sideways. Now we're in a similar position where we're right now in that channel where Litecoin did that months and months ago in the fall. But instead of going up and then trading sideways, what we're looking for is to get that evening out on the 50 EMA from going down. We want to stop going down. And the first indicator of that stopping is really that 50 EMA. We want to see it just level out and go sideways. So we're going down the 50, sideways, up on the 50, sideways. So what might lend a hand in that happening is this channel. So we want to see if there is support in this channel, like the $65 to around $47. It's a really interesting channel for me to watch. You can see, because also we wicked right down to 49, very close to this. It's kind of almost like a double bottom, but not really. But I see some support possibly being here, but you really just got to be on the lookout right now. Anything can happen. We can go back to this other chart and really even, I mean, if you want to get a, we're not too far into this wedge, but we can still do this, which is to say, possibly measure the length of that wedge. If we get a breakdown, where might we go to next? And really from here, it's around a $45 or so Litecoin. So right now we're at $51, $45, another 10% loss, possibly, if we break this lower trend line. One thing that is good is we're not in that overbought area on the stock RSI, which usually we know what happens when we are. So we have some upside potential right now. It's just a matter of looking at your portfolio, making sure you're feeling okay, not getting too emotional. Try not to FOMO. Try not to spend more than you can afford to lose. This is definitely not financial advice, but be careful out there. It's crazy. It is crazy. I really appreciate it. It's been fun doing a technical analysis video. It's been a while, been a busy week. I really appreciate each and every one of you. I'm grateful for all of you. Thank you so much for coming by. I will see you in the next video, and God bless.